What's up, everybody? Today we're going to be having a very rare segment that is featured on my channel called Real Talk with LCD. Now, this is not a gaming-related video whatsoever, but every once in a while I like to use my channel as an outlet to kind of speak my mind and discuss some hot topics that are happening throughout the world. And today's hot topic or topic for Real Talk with LCD is, of course, my boy Pil Cosby. Now, as you guys know, Pil Cosby has been accused over the last several months of rape allegations that he did decades ago, probably around the time that he was filming his show, The Cosby Show. Now, the reason I want to talk about this is because it's very, very interesting to me. Not interesting in a way that, oh my God, I gotta research this and talk about it and, you know, go on the news and go to Wikipedia. It's not like that for me. This subject is more interesting in the fact that this is a very widely renowned and beloved actor, comedian, Pil Cosby, that is now being looked in the eyes of the community as this rapist or this convicted felon or this guy who is terrible all of a sudden, right? In my opinion, well, first of all, in today's news, if you haven't heard already, today as of December 30th, 2015, Pil Cosby was actually indicted and arrested. And later that same day, he actually made bail. It was $1 million bail, but he is no longer in jail. And of course, this is all going back to those allegations of rape that not just one, two, three, or four, but several women, I believe up to 15 now, have actually come forward saying that he drugged them and gave them pills without her consent and, you know, essentially just raping them or raping these women. And the reason I want to talk about this is because just to overall talk about why I think this is interesting to me. I think this is interesting to me because of the fact that this is a beloved actor and comedian, like I said earlier, who is widely renowned for his show, The Cosby Show, and, you know, it influenced a lot of young kids and even young adults today growing up, including myself. And I've always liked Bill Cosby, Pil Cosby, whatever you want to call him. Pil Cosby is, well, I used to think, an awesome guy, right? Like, he was really funny. I loved his shows. I loved him when he was in a few movies that I've seen. And it kind of changes your perspective on these things, right? This guy is almost 80 years old. I believe he's 79. And when you have a person that you've looked up to your entire life now being accused of rape allegations, it just makes you think, right? It actually makes you think, wow, I used to love this guy and now I absolutely hate his guts. But for me, it's not like that. Other people might think that way. You know, they say, like Michael Jackson. Michael Jackson is the king of pop. He's one of the most famously known and best musicians that have ever lived in the 20th and 21st century. But after he got accused of those molestation charges on these kids, everyone looked at him in a different way. This is the king of pop, the guy that I looked up to, the guy whose music I freaking, you know, fell in love with or went to every single one of his concerts. And now this guy's being charged of child molestation. And now it's just like, wow, I hate his guts now. But for me, I don't really think that way. It's not like when this stuff happens, it's not like I have to stop listening to this guy's music, right? The music is still good. I don't combine the two. Sure, Michael Jackson is the one who recorded the music, but it's the music itself that stands out, not Michael Jackson. I don't need Michael Jackson to enjoy the music, right? The music is always going to be there. It's forever. It's eternal. But Michael Jackson, he's dead. He's long gone. You know, rest his soul, whether he was accused of it or not. I'll leave it up to you guys for your own beliefs. But for me, I will always enjoy Michael Jackson's music. You get it? Like, for some people out there, even though they loved his music before, now they just all of a sudden stopped liking his music because he got accused of the child molestation charges, right? So I don't think that way. I'm still going to enjoy his music. The music didn't do anything wrong. His music didn't, you know, molest these kids. He did, not the music. So that's a really quick example of how I think about these things in a different perspective. Now, personally for me, I think that I'm not going to go ahead and say whether or not I think Bill Cosby did it because, quite honestly, anything is possible in 2015 going into 2016. You have all these people who are trying to get rich whatever the case may be, right? I bet some of these women probably may be telling the truth. The other half probably not. You know, they're just following suit because all these other women started it first. You know, you never can tell with someone's, you know, unless there's hard evidence, there's, you know, physical DNA or something like that. It's really, really hard to tell if, you know, something that happened 20, 30, 40 years ago actually happened from this woman's story who's just now coming forward, right? Something just doesn't click there. I mean, why? Obviously, you know, there's that scared potential. He's going to kill me if I tell anybody, you know, I got to keep it secret, or he's going to kill me or do something crazy, right? Or I'll kill your family, you know. That's a murderous perspective, right? Now, rape is a very, very serious thing. And so when these women, half of them may be telling the truth, half of them may not be, when people come forward and say, this guy raped me, he drugged me 20, 30 years ago, that's got to ring a bell in someone's head, right? Well, why were you just now coming forward? Why didn't you come forward when this crap probably actually still mattered? And keep in mind, obviously it still matters. If you committed a murder 30 years ago, or if you raped someone 30 years ago, that doesn't matter how long it's been. You did the crime, you should do the time and pay for your mistake, or your murder, or whatever it is. I mean, obviously, if you robbed a store like 30 years ago, I mean, that's not as big of a deal as murder, right? If you robbed a convenience store 30 years ago down the street because you were a kid and didn't know any better, I mean, come on. Nobody's going to indict you for that. But I mean, rape and murder, that stuff lasts forever. That child, that mother's son, her son is never going to come back, right? That's murder. They'll never get their child back. So that's way different than robbing a convenience store. So I just wanted to get that out of the way real quick. So the fact that I'm a twitching YouTuber, right? I'm a twitching YouTuber. I deal with video games and online personalities and people who just talk crap all day long. So you have all these kids online who are like, I just raped you. I raped you, son. Get wrecked in Call of Duty. Get raped. You know, I hate it when I hear that stuff because it just makes me sick. You guys know me on my Twitch chat. I do not allow the word rape or retarded whatsoever because I just don't want to be a part of that stuff. You know, I take rape very seriously. It's a very serious matter. And so when you have all these kids just using it as all casually, I just raped you, son, you got raped. You know, it's disgusting if you really think about it, because these kids are growing up with no morals these days. They just think they can say and do whatever they want and nobody's going to care, because as society changes and so do our kids, you know, they grow up thinking that just everything's okay and everything, there's no limits to anything, right? So when you have these women come forward and say, oh, this guy raped me 40 years ago, you know, how can someone do that? Especially if they're not telling the truth. If they're just making these stories up to try to get some money, you know. Bill Cosby's 79 years old. How could you do that to someone who's almost 80 years old? How? Especially if it's not true. If it is true, fine. I'm perfectly okay with that. What I'm not okay with is the fact that, you know, some of these women could be telling the truth and some of them could not be telling the truth. They're only coming out about it or making up some false story because of the fact that these other women did it and they're seeing it as kind of like a cash grab. Oh, these other women are doing it now. I can take it. I can use my advantage or something like that, right? They fit that profile. They were at this place in such and such time with Bill Cosby. They can make up some bogus excuse about some story that never actually ever happened, right? So again, I'm not saying he did or didn't do it. I'm just saying there's a possibility that some of these women could be lying. There's a possibility some of them could be telling the truth, right? I'm not taking anybody's side here. However, you do have to feel some sympathy for Bill Cosby. Poor Bill Cosby, man. Like I said, if he gets convicted in the court of law, it's gonna suck for him. Like I said, because he's 79 years old, and to be in prison at 79 probably wouldn't be a good thing. And it also depends on how long his sentence would be as well. Like if he just got a life sentence, 20, 30 years, especially if they convict him based on how many women, like they find out that if it's just one woman, he might not get as long a sentence as, you know, if they convicted him for, you know, raping 5 or 10 women, you know. There, like I said, there's up to 15 women who are now making these claims, and that's a lot of prison time, Pill Cosby. That's a lot of prison time. So shout outs to my boy Pill. I mean, again, he gave me an amazing childhood. I grew up watching The Cosby Show. I grew up watching a lot of his stuff. But I even went online to actually find some of his comedian stuff. You know, Kids Say the Darndest Things, a lot of that stuff. And it's still funny. No matter how you look at this guy, you know, from your perspective, it's still good material. You know, his show is still teaching a lot of kids morals. It's a really good show. You know, it's TV. It's acting. He's playing a character on TV. That is not the real Bill Cosby on The Cosby Show. He is playing a character named Heathcliff. I mean, come on. So, you know, the stuff that he's teaching on that show is still good stuff. Obviously, he didn't follow it if he does end up being convicted, but, you know, the point still remains the same. So I don't know what you guys think. Obviously, this is real talk with LCD. This is a very serious matter, so please be respectful in the comments when you guys are commenting on this this video. And you guys are probably wondering, why do I keep calling him Pill Cosby? I just think it's hilarious. Like I said, I find this stuff very, very interesting. And if you can make a joke out of, I'm not trying to make a joke out of rape. I'm making a joke out of Bill Cosby. You know, it just makes sense. His name is Bill Cosby, you know, the pills you drug. It's funny. But anyways, let me know what you guys think in the comment section. I'm out of here. Thank you guys for watching.
You win.
Take the red pill. You stay in Wonderland. And I show you how deep the rabbit hole goes.
Oh. Put Molly all in her champagne. She ain't eating up. I took her home and I enjoyed that.
Here's a second look. Taken off, the patented tongue comes out. Just in front of it.
Unbelievable.